Well, a day after that all-important meeting that took place on the third anniversary of UPA2, where we saw senior leader Mulayam Singh Yadav share the dais with Sonia Gandhi, a meeting in which political realignment was very much the focus. What does this really mean for the UPA government? Well, a day after all of that happened, and a lot of political pundits began reading into that meeting and what it signifies, particularly with the equation of the UPA, of the Congress specifically, and the Trinamool Congress, whether now with Mulayam Singh playing possibly a more active role in the UPA, the role of the Trinamool Congress would perhaps go down to a certain extent. Well, just a day after that all-important meeting took place, comes news that the government has, just in the last little while, increased the price of petrol by 7 rupees 50 paise per litre. And this is just news coming in of a petrol price hike. We are unclear at this stage whether there would be some sort of change in diesel prices as well. Well, we're going to discuss the political dynamics between the Samajwadi Party and the Congress in a moment. But I've also joined at this stage by the senior Congress leader, Satyavrat Chaturvedi, Shahid Siddiqui of the Samajwadi Party, Pinaki Mishra of the BJD, and the senior journalist, Siddharth Bhatia, to perhaps reflect on all of this. Mr. Chaturvedi, if I can come to you first, sir. This really has turned out to be the news of the day. 7 rupees 50 paise a litre, the sharpest ever hike in the price of petrol. How can the Congress, which speaks for the Aam Aadmi, justify this?
Well, we all know that the international prices of petroleum products is shooting up in the international market. And in the recent Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha sessions, we have had discussion on this issue. And there was a general understanding of the fact that it is high time that we cannot go on burdening our petrol companies and petrol and the oil companies anymore. So it was expected that petrol prices perhaps may go up. The rise of prices is little too much. Yes, it's pinching, no doubt about it. But because of the fact that we have been subsidizing on diesel, we have been subsidizing on kerosene, we have been subsidizing heavily on LPG, these are the areas which are highly subsidized even now. And therefore, maybe the burden is little too much. I think people understand the compulsions of international prices going up.
Shahid Bhai, it's quite clear one way or the other that in the last 24 hours, the Samajwadi Party is closer to the Congress, irrespective of what shape that ultimately takes. But a decision like this, doesn't that make you rethink that decision or rethink where your equation with the Congress is going?
You see, Mulayam Singh ji, even during the election when Congress was attacking us right, left and the center, was very clearly saying whatever the election verdict, we will go on supporting the UPA. So it has nothing to do with what they are doing now or what they will be doing tomorrow and with the rise and fall of the petroleum market. Okay. So it has nothing to do with that. It has many things to do with many other issues. But the price rise of the petroleum was expected by everyone, but not to this extent. And this requires a rethink on the very fundamentals of the petroleum policy. Government should go into that, should talk to all the parties, because I think even their allies who are part of the UPA government will not accept this and will be extremely critical of this huge price rise.
But let me just probe this question a little bit further. It's very clear that one way or the other, Mamata Banerjee, who has opposed a petrol price hike in the past and something that the government accepted, now you've got the Samajwadi Party, which is playing a more important role. So will you accept, or will you accept the government going ahead with a 7 rupee 50 paise hike? Because Mamata won't. Will the Samajwadi Party say, okay, fine, you've taken this decision, we'll accept it?
No, we are not accepting it. What we are saying is that there should be a rethink on the policy, because price rises, petroleum price rise is one thing, but the rise in the taxes, you know, the proportional rise in the taxes is not acceptable. So the taxes, both by the states and by the center, have to come down. You see, you can't justify the rise in taxation. So there has to be a rethink on the basic fundamental policy, and I think that is what we should go into instead of, you know, looking for immediate alibis or political reasons and not political reasons. There are economic reasons, of course, but there are also ways out of this, and you cannot allow this kind of price rise to, this is the heaviest burden on the common man, and everybody will resent it and oppose it. It's not a question of our party. It's, even the congressman, I'm sure, will not be very happy with what has happened.
Do you have the NDTV Profit app? All the markets, all the news in your own homemade, ready-made portfolio available there for you.
We will right now answer what you should sell, what you should buy when markets are down.
Download at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Get the best app from the channel you trust.